During these strange times, two Microsoft platforms have empowered people to work from home, and that is Teams and Windows Virtual Desktop. Until now, Teams has not been fully supported in WVD. You could use it for chat and collaboration, but all the audio and video features were not yet supported. And the reason why, well, how about I let Scott Manchester and Jeremy Chapman explain?
Well, in the before environment, we were taking the AV stream and it was being sent from your device to the host VM, where it is getting encoded and decoded multiple times before it gets to the other end of the call. And obviously that latency reduces the quality and performance of your video. Now, re-encoding on your VM is also CPU intensive and could impact other users who might also be on that machine. Now, with AV redirection for Teams, we essentially redirect the Teams AV traffic to bypass the Windows Virtual Desktop virtual machine and send the audio and video data directly to one call client to the other.
Now, this video was uploaded to the Microsoft Mechanics YouTube channel back in September of 2019, which I'll have linked in the description down below. So the problem, clearly, is that extra latency and processing in the cloud going through WVD is not ideal for any of these unified communication systems. And I am very happy to say that as of today, AV redirection is a reality and you can use it right now. So come with me down the rabbit hole and learn how we can finally combine the full potential of Windows Virtual Desktop and Microsoft Teams. I'm Dean Cifola and this is the Azure Academy. So our story begins today, as most of them do, at the Azure Academy with the Azure documentation. And in the docs, we'll scroll down to go to Windows Virtual Desktop, and over in our filter here on the left, we'll type in Teams, and we'll click on the link for Use Microsoft Teams. And right off the top, we've got an important box that's highlighting that Teams is in public preview and it's currently being evaluated and certain features may not yet work. And to see more about that, over on the right, there is a link for known issues and limitations, which you can look through in the documentation. And as always, the product group is looking for your feedback. So there is a link right over here on the right for feedback. Takes you right out to user voice and you can submit all of your feedback items there. And that way we can make the product better for everybody. And let's go back to the prerequisites link here, just so we're all on the same page. Obviously, you will need to prepare your network for using Microsoft Teams. We'll need to install the Teams client. And that means the Windows 10 platform that we're installing it on needs to meet the Teams minimum requirements on the hardware side. And we need to use Windows 10 multi-session or Windows 10 Enterprise as our virtual machine platform. So the basic process is we're going to install Teams, need to add a registry key, and then we need to install the WebSocket service, which is another MSI. And then we need to configure the host pool so that it can be ready to support Teams. And then we'll do some testing and show how the AV features actually work. And in the WVD admin portal, I've got two host pools set up, one for personal desktops and the other one is a pooled host pool, and that's for hosting my remote apps. And we just have one remote app group set up right now for Teams. And then those are shared in the same workspace. So we're logged in now to that personal host pool as an admin, not through WVD. This way we can install Teams. But before we do, I'm just really excited to show you this. I'm going to right click on start and go to run. And I'm going to type WinVir. And this is showing that we are using the latest version of Windows 10 version 2004. And on top of many new features that's in this version of Windows, one of them is native support for MSIX and AppAttach. And this feature has been long awaited. I did the first video on MSIX AppAttach back in November 2019. And at the time you needed to use a insider version of Windows 10 in order to access that feature, but now it is public and anybody can leverage it. In my Windows File Explorer, I'll go to my DFS share and I've got a folder here for AppAttach. And you can see three hard drives here and those are already pre-configured for AppAttach. And I do have a scripts directory here and I'll open these in PowerShell. And this is for an application that's called MicroDICOM. And at the moment you can see I do not have it installed at all. I'll just run our first script, which will mount the virtual hard drive. And then we'll run the AppAttach. And then under our start menu, you can see there MicroDICOM has been added. And there the app is running. And if we open the Windows Disk Manager, you can see it's attached here as a virtual hard drive. So no other work necessary. Just have everything pre-staged, connect and run. Then of course we can unmount everything just as easily and then destage the virtual hard drive. And these of course can be added to group policy scripts so that they run in an automated manner. And this product is still being improved. So if you are interested in AppAttach, then give me some more comments and feedback down below and I'll be sure to pass that off to the product group. All right, so that was all free. Let's get back into Teams. So the first thing that we're going to do is download the WebSocket service. And just in case we run into an issue with that, we'll also download the Microsoft Visual C++ redistributable package. And then we'll also download the Teams MSI package. So we'll click on the WebSocket. And if you see this MSI being blocked, just choose to keep it and then go under show more and then do keep anyway. And then we'll open the redistributable in a new tab. And we want the one for 64-bit in this case. And then down here we have the Teams MSI package. And that'll take us over to another page in the docs where we can see how to install Teams in a VDI environment. And over on the right, we can click the install or update Teams desktop app on VDI. Then we do have to scroll down a bit more until we find the deploy the Teams desktop app to the VM and download the 64-bit version. And now that we've got those installers all downloaded, we need to add a reg key. And under H key, local machine, we'll go to software, then Microsoft. Then we need to add a new key for Teams, which I have already done. And then we need to add a reg D word for is WVD environment and set the value to 1. And once that's done, we'll install our WebSocket service. We'll accept the terms and hit install and then say yes and finish. And since we did not have an issue running that installer, we don't need to run the Visual C++ redistributable package. We can just go ahead and install Teams. Now, according to the documentation, we can just copy the command here for the MSI installer. And I've added the path for my MSI file for Teams, and I'm using a log here called teamsinstall.log. And then we'll run this installation. And if all has gone according to plan in add remove programs, you should see the Teams machine wide installer and also the remote desktop web RTC service. And we've got the icon for Teams on our desktop and I'll launch that and I'll provide my credentials. And since I'm using multi-factor authentication on my account, I've got to enter that code. And Teams is now installed. Now, back inside the WVD docs, we've got a second note here, and that is that if you want the media optimization to be working in Teams, then you need to be using the Windows Desktop WVD client. Currently, it's not supported on any other platform or the web client. You need to use the actual desktop version, and that version needs to be 1.2.1026 or later. And if your client is not up to date, you'll get a little banner up here telling you to download the latest version. Mine, however, is already up to date, and this version was just released in the last couple days from this recording. And I'll launch my personal desktop. And there we are, logged in as Adam Warlock, and Teams is going to launch automatically for us. All right, and the important thing to verify, if we click on our little icon up here in the top right, under About, we go to Version, and we can see that we have Teams version 1.3.0.4461, and it says WVD Media Optimized, all right? That is the important key to know that AV Redirection is working. Now, before we can do a call, we actually need to set up our host pool. Back in the Azure docs, and at the very bottom, there is the Customize RDP Protocol Properties for Host Pool Setting. And these are the ones that we need in order to pass our camera and microphone into our virtualized environment. Now, the audio capture and audio mode are available in the portal, but camera redirection is not. In the WVD admin portal in our host pool, we'll go to Properties and then go to the RDP settings. And down here at the bottom is the audio input and output. So the audio input is that audio capture mode that we just saw, and the audio mode is what determines if the sounds play on your computer or on the remote computer in the cloud. So for something like this, we want sounds to play on this computer, meaning the one that we're logging onto with our client, and we need both of these to be turned on. For the camera, we need PowerShell. So we'll go back to the dock real quick, and in the filter, we'll type PowerShell. And we'll go to setting up the PowerShell module, and we'll scroll down a little bit. Here is the command that you'll need in order to set up the PowerShell module. And for these new modules, we'll just do a normal connect to Azure with the connect-az account. We don't need the add RDS account command for this. And then you scroll down, you may have to select your subscription if you have more than one, and then we can do all the PowerShell work. So I've already set up the module, as you can see here over on the left, and I have logged into Azure already. So over on the right, I've got a couple variables here for the resource group and host pool name. I'm creating a host pool variable that's called HP, and then we can parse out of that the custom RDP properties. So what I did was copied over here from the custom RDP properties all of the stuff that was from all the audio mode and everything else that was here. And then I added to it over here on the right side the camera redirect property, and using the asterisk just like the documentation said, so that I pass all camera devices into the cloud. And then we run our update, and that configures everything. And of course you can validate that through the first set of commands that we ran. And there you can see the camera redirect, audio mode, and audio capture mode are set up. So let's jump back into our VM and test this. And log back into our personal desktop in Teams. We'll go up to our profile picture, go to settings, and then go to our devices. Scroll down just a bit, and there is our video. And I've got a Logitech Brio here, which is a pretty good webcam. And this is something that you're going to find is dependent on what kind of camera you're using as to the performance that you get, as to the kind of lighting that you have. So all of that gets affected here. And come to think of it, I think this is the first time I've ever actually appeared in one of my videos. So hi, everybody. This is where we make the Azure Academy. And let's do a video test here with another system. Oh, looks like Nova wants to do a video call, so let's do that. And I'll just accept this on my other machine. So at this point, you're hearing echo. Two mics, very close. And I have muted the mic on my other laptop device here, but let me make this full screen. All right, and here is our shared video call between Nova and Adam Warlock. So we've got Adam on the personal desktop. Nova is actually running this as a remote application, so it works in both situations just as well. And this is what things look like from the Surface Book side. And you can see that the title here of the Teams app, Microsoft Teams over WVD Workspace, and things actually look very well. So I can still move very, very cleanly, and everything looks great. And that's again because of those AV redirection features. And here's where we put it all together. You've got what the Brio sees directly on the bottom right, and then what the Surface Book is picking up over here, and then what the Surface Book is viewing over on the left. So you can see us all from every angle. And this is probably a good time to mention that we're actually gonna do a live Q&A on the coming weeks here, so keep an eye out for that. And that way you can interact with me directly, and we'll be doing that pretty soon. And I may even bring a few friends with me who are specialists in other areas of Azure. Maybe we can convince some of them to start making some videos too. And keep in mind that this is a preview feature in WVD right now, so we definitely want feedback. We want to make this product as good as it can be. So any issues, problems, feature requests, that kind of thing that you have, please put that in user voice or in the comments down below, and I will be sure to pass those on to the product group. So I hope that you've enjoyed looking at the preview feature of Teams AV Redirection in Windows Virtual Desktop, and a really great achievement for all unified communication software. So if you like this video or learned something new new today, go ahead and click that thumbs up and let me know that you've appreciated our video. And if you're not yet subscribed to the Azure Academy, what are you waiting for? Click that subscribe button and join us here at our community, where we just want to help everybody learn all about Azure. And if you have any questions, comments, or requests for videos that we haven't yet done on the Azure Academy, definitely give me those down below in the comments section, and I'll be happy to make that video for you. And speaking of interest, over here on the top right, we've got our latest video on the Azure Academy, so go check that out. And over here on the bottom, we've got a video that we picked out just for you to help you to keep learning about Azure. Thanks very much for joining us today, and we will see you in the next video. Happy learning.